Welcome all, it's Russ. And in this video, we're going to talk about Python functions. Python functions are declared with the DEF keyword. Now in Python, just like variables don't declare their types, the same is true with return types and parameters in Python. So let's create a function foo. It's going to have variable or parameters x and y. So whoever calls foo, of course, needs to pass exactly two parameters. We don't have any control over what those values are. They could be strings, they could be integers, they could be dictionaries, they could be file objects, whatever. Inside the body, we can do anything that we've seen so far. We can call other functions, we can have loops, you name it. At some point, if you want, you can do a return statement. Let's return x plus y. All right, so a return statement means that the value that someone else sees, the return value from this function, will be whatever you give. If you choose to simply write return with no value at all, or if your function simply terminates, it gets to the bottom of the function and falls out of it without any return statement, then actually Python returns a special value. It's the equivalent of returning something called none. Now, we're not going to go in detail about what return none means yet. When we talk about references, we'll start to understand what none exactly means. But for now, most of your functions should either do an explicit return or a return, an explicit return with no value or with a value like this. Trying to think what you need to know that we haven't already covered implicitly. I'm making the assumption here that whatever language you're coming from, you've already seen functions a lot, you've already used functions a lot, so you probably don't need a lot of the details because it's going to be the same in Python. But I guess let's give a few examples. So we've got our function foo. So what could we do? Well, we could call foo of 10, 20. Let's actually put foo over here. All right, so over here we will say a equals foo of 10, 20. Well, what's going to happen? Well, it's first going to print 10, then it's going to print 20, and then it's going to return 10 plus 20, set that equal to A. So let's print A, so it prints 30. Obviously, whatever you have in here could be more complex expressions. Let's just call foo itself inside, just for fun. B equals foo of foo. 1, 2, 3. That's an interesting little problem. All right, so what are you really asking to do? You're asking the programming language to call foo and then also call foo a second time. But in what order do they get called? To understand this, you always have to think that in programming languages, they generally start with the smallest things and they build outward. So really what happens if we're, let me put in red, the process of how we evaluate things. So they look at this value 1, we figure out, okay, value 1, there it is. This is not, you know, individual constants are not particularly interesting. But it figures out, okay, 1 and 2. Now, we have the two parameters necessary for a foo call. So now what it's going to do is it's going to execute this foo call. It's going to call foo of 1, 2. All right, so what happens? Foo will run, it will print out 1, it'll print out 2, and then what is returned from this? It returns 1 plus 2. Okay, so it returns the value 3. So it was foo 1 comma 2, but now 3 is the value that we've got here. This now allows it to run here. And what it's going to run is another call of foo, where the first parameter is 3, and the second parameter is also 3. So we've called foo once, now we're going to call foo again. Now both the parameters are 3. So what is this going to return? This is going to return 6. So B is 6. If we print B, we're going to get the value 6. All right. Let's do something else. C equals foo of bar 4 baz 7 9. All right, so let's write out what bar and baz are going to be. I'm just going to invent these as we go. Let's say that bar takes a parameter x. It will print out x, and then it will return the square of x, x times x. Then we have baz of x, y will return x times y. Oh, let's print it as well. Print x. Sorry that I'm inserting here. All right, so bar is going to print out its parameter, then return the square of it. Baz will print out its two parameters, and then return the square, or return their product. All right, so how do we evaluate this function call here? We call bar. We have the value 4 that's been passed to it. All right, so it's going to print out 4. Then it's going to return 4 squared. So this becomes 16. Then it's going to call baz. It will print out both of its parameters, 7, 9. Then it returns their product, which is 63. Now we call foo. We pass it 16 and 63. So foo will print out 16 and 63. What is foo going to return? It's going to return the sum, 16 plus 63. The value will be 79. Fell off the bottom of the picture. I apologize, but that's a 79 down there. All right, so this is functions. There's nothing particularly different about how they work in Python as opposed to how they work in other languages. That's a pretty good quick summary of them. Let's do one more thing before I go. I'm going to erase all of this and do one more example. I told you that Python doesn't control what the types of things are. What if you say foo of A, B, C, D, E, F? What do you expect that it would print out? Well, we're passing A, B, C as the first parameter, D, E, F is the second parameter. So X is A, B, C, D, E, F is Y. So it's going to print A, B, C, D, E, F. What does it return? I said it returns the sum, but that's not technically true. What it actually returns is x plus y. And if x and y are strings, then what does the plus operator do? It does concatenation. So in this case, A would return the string A, B, C, D, E, F. And that's just to illustrate the point that in Python, because we don't declare the types of our parameters or our return type, you can sometimes have functions that will work correctly in some very strange sorts of ways. We can argue about whether this is a bug or whether it's a feature of this particular program, but it is how it's going to work in Python. All right, well, I hope you've learned a lot about Python functions, what the syntax is at least. Hopefully you came in with a good understanding of functions before you got here. We'll be talking about it more as we go. See you later. Bye-bye.